Er det okay, jeg snakker engelsk?
Ja, gør det godt.
All right. People today, they go out age 25 and they get a pension. Age 25, they worry about what's going to happen when they're 65. The banks are telling us to think about that sort of thing. You can have a prepaid funeral today so that there's no trouble when it happens. I mean, what kind of a world is it that we don't let ourselves live while we do it? Being aware of the fact that it has an end and we don't know when it happens can be a very strong motivation for life, for enjoying every second that we have of it, enjoying every second that we can use to tell stories, to enjoy the other people on this beautiful, wonderful planet. I just think it's so important to remember that we don't live forever and to spend that time remaining, that short remaining time, in the very best way. I'm gonna show you what flying means to me. Take a look at this flying machine. Now, I'm looking at it in the sense of a sculpture. It's beautiful. It looks incredibly beautiful. I've always wanted to build my own airplane. I wanted it since I was a kid. And I didn't know how to solve that puzzle. I knew that I could maybe, you know, unbolt the engine from my dad's car.
No, we don't normally do Volvo safety testing like this.
I often ask my dad about the possibility, the feasibility of using a car engine as an aeroplane engine. And he kept on telling me that aeroplane engines needed to be air-cooled and that aeroplane engines needed to be made from aluminum. And they needed to be very light, and certainly you could not use the engine of a Volvo in an airplane, because he was genuinely fearing that I would unscrew the car's engine and he would come into the garage one day only to realize that the engine had gone and that Peter had disappeared in his homemade aircraft. Russians have just launched Yuri Gagarin into the Vostok, and the Americans are really fighting to catch up with them. They know what's happening in Baikonur, they know they have to catch up. And so they start the making of the Mercury spacecraft, which is incredibly small. It's only 1.8 meters diameter, it's a cone, so in fact, you can put a Mercury capsule on this table, and it'll only stick out a little bit at either end. And I watched this on television back then when I'm no more, you know, 9 years old, and I see them strapping Commander Shepard, Alan Shepard, smiling Shepard, smiling Alan, into the capsule, and they seal the hatch and they light this redstone rocket, and they launch it, and he goes 180 kilometers into space, and flies a couple of hundred kilometers over the ocean and lands off the island of Bermuda. And during that process, he flies with a velocity of over 7,000 kilometers per hour. And I started 9 years old looking at this and thinking, what would it take to do something like that? And I climbed underneath my table in my room, and I tried to find out how small I could become. And it might conceivably become possible to build a rocket and launch it with myself into space. I present to you the most powerful machine ever conceived by mankind. This is a model of the 110 meter tall Saturn launch vehicle. It has more muscle power than anything that we have ever built as humanity. And most importantly, this is the first rocket in history that has the capability of launching a manned spacecraft out of Earth's gravitational field.
Coming up on the 2 minute mark on the Apollo 8 mission, 2 minutes and counting.
Du ved, det er historiens store øjeblik, det her. Det er første raket til månen nogensinde. Det er ikke Apollo 11, det er Apollo 8, som er den første gang, man flyver derop. On this one, Wernher von Braun decides, with lots of debate, And they're going to go for an all-up strategy and try to stab the whole thing and launch the whole thing together. All spaceflight up until then, every manned mission up until then have been around and around and around and around.
We have ignition sequence start.
On which energy? Say to our team. Det er tredje gang, de flyver en Saturn, og det er første gang, de har mennesker på den. Så det er kun tredje gang, de har prøvet den her kæmpe store nye. The five F1 engines of the first stage are burning 13 tons of rocket propellants per second. Vi kan høre Flight Director Gene Trance kommunikere med hans forskellige folk i Mission Control. Saturn-raketten er en 3-trins-raket, så det de er sindssygt bange for, det er, at de får andet trin til at starte, når første trin er brændt ud. Nu knokler den op igennem atmosfæren her. Nu kan se, at de går gennem lydmuren på chokbølgen og dans rundt om. Man kan høre, de snakker om, at raketten er stadigvæk rigtig på banen. Og har ikke afgivet urimelig meget fra kursen.
You're now hearing the voice of Paul Haney at Mission Control in Houston.
Into the mission, and Frank Borman has confirmed each event as it's been passed to him by Mike Collins at this point.
Vi udvider flammen, så fordi vi ikke kommer op i den tynde luft øverst i atmosfæren, så der ikke er noget til at klemme flammen sammen, så der kommer det her fænomen, at det bliver en kæmpe flamme, der breder sig væk i Saturn. Og det, der nu er den næste flight event, som er så spændende for dem, det er, om de kan lykkes med, det er, at de slukker motorerne på første trin, og så skal de skille første trinet fra, og så skal de have alle fem brintmotorer til at virke på anden trin.
Going 3,000 miles an hour.
Så slukkede de første trin.
And there is the
staging. See the first stage cut off. S2.
Og separeret, og fem motorer tænder på andet trin. All engines good. Man kan høre, hvor meget okay, vi kommer til månen. Den tændte. Andet trin er tændt. Og det er super kritisk at få gang i en brintmotor ude i verdensrummet, hvor der ikke er noget luft. Det er super, super vanskeligt.
S2 has ignited, we can confirm. And the thrust looks good. All engines, all sorts.
As they reach the lunar vicinity, all that we have left of the spacecraft is this part. This is the command module and service module of the Apollo 8. And if nobody does anything, they're just going to pass the moon and they're going to get lost into deep space with no chance of ever returning to Earth. The only thing they have on the ship that can stop that is this engine. That engine had never been fired in history before. It was brand new. They count down and they switch it on. And it burns. It's hammering away for the exact number of seconds to change the trajectory into a lunar orbit. And a few minutes later, Apollo 8 is orbiting not the Earth, but the Moon.
Så kører vi igen.
Sequencer now, that we have the auto sequence system is go, and we are T-minus 30 seconds. This means this time, there's an overwhelming chance for ignition. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3,
2, 1, go.
We can confirm that we have had a flight. We can confirm we have had separation.
And parachutes deploying. There has been mission anomalies. We're now analyzing and commencing recovery operations. Peter?
Thank you for having me. Og kæft, er sløjten flot.
Ja. Jeg så det ikke, vel? Hvad synes du om min kommentar?
Det er raketbane.
Er det her nedslag?
Ja. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Straight up aiming for a point in the sky directly above the launch platform.